Greetings, Eric Packer from New Zealand, the naturopath from down under. Thanks for coming back and looking at my channel. I often get asked about the products that I make, you know, for various companies that I've made over the years. But one question I get asked quite a lot is, why do you put the probiotics in your CanXida Restore that you do? Why don't you put other strains in there? For example, this subscriber here says, would you consider adding or recommend using other species or strains like L. roturi MMA4-1A PTA6475 for immune T cell regulation or interleukin 10 to downregulate pro-inflammatory immune responses or other reasons? Did you understand any of that stuff? Well, I'll tell you why I made this product. I made CanXida Restore because I used so many different probiotics over the years and so many enzyme formulas. And then I tried combinations, you know, using together. And I found that patients benefited much more when good quality enzymes and probiotics were married together. Now, we can debate, you know, for weeks and months and years about which particular strains are going to work. But in the end, I don't think it makes a great deal of difference. And this is why. The important thing is to look at a probiotic really from a concept where you're looking at strains that have been proven scientifically to work very well, but they're used in conjunction with the right kind of enzymes and diet. So you've got to eat a specific way, you've got to live a specific way, and then the bacteria are the icing on the cake. There's no point in looking at highly specific strains of bacteria if you haven't got everything else, you know, working reasonably well for you in your diet. The two most researched strains of lactobacillus, in my opinion, for the immune system, would be lactobacillus rhamnosus and lactobacillus plantarum. And one of the most researched strains of all lactobacilli is lactobacillus acidophilus DDS1, Department of Dairy Science -1, which was studied by Dr. Ken Shahani from Nebraska for over 25 years. Dr. Shahani was America's leading microbiologist in the 60s and 70s, who did most of the groundbreaking initial work on lactobacillus. And his son, Michael Shahani, has taken over the company. So I've had quite a thorough look at probiotics and discovered that the DDS1 was one of the most important strains to use in my formula. And that's why I put it in CanXida Restore. I've also used a high quality American lactobacillus rhamnosus and lactobacillus plantarum. So putting those three lacto strains together along with, you know, enzymes like amylase, it's working well. It's working well. If something works, why would you want to change it? There's no point making highly specific strain formulas unless we're using it for highly specific conditions, which I'm not doing. CanXida Restore is a broad spectrum enzyme probiotic designed to be used for people with a multitude of problems. It's not a super heavy duty product, but it's not a super light duty product. It seems to fit the bill for thousands of people that have used it. The feedback's been very, very good. It's a product I use every day in my clinic now for several years, and occasionally we get feedback that's not so good, but it's in a minority. The bulk of people who use the product get a good outcome. And for that reason, I'm not going to change it. There's no point changing something that works. So why would we want to up or down regulate specific interleukins? These are very, very difficult things to achieve. Doctors have tried to do this by using biologic drugs for psoriasis, for example, but trying to manipulate interleukins, and it doesn't work. When you get in there and try and up or down regulate a particular a pro or anti-inflammatory mediator in the body, you're going to create another problem. It's like a whack-a-mole game. You whack the hippopotamus's head down, it's going to pop up somewhere else. Doing very specific things in the body will create very specific outcomes. That's the point I'm making. By using something that's broad, has a broad action and it's high quality, you're much better off, in my opinion, doing that because you're not really going to get very strong particular outcomes. I have used very specific strains with patients before, but found either they had zero action in the body completely, or they produced a powerful effect in that patient, the effect that I wasn't really looking for. So that's why I stick with basic probiotics like rhamnosus, plantarum, caseide, bifidolongum, bifidobifidus. These are the ones I really like to use because in my experience, these are the ones that just work on the majority of patients. And that's all there is to it. Thanks for tuning in.